So welcome to this edition of a chat with the chairs that we have started. It is a proud privilege and honor to have with us Sri Pankaj Satija, who actually not only is the co-chair of a mining committee, but is a member of the steel committee and is the chief regulatory officer with Tata Steel. Thank you, Mr. Satija, for joining us. This discussion is primarily on the steel sector. And if I may begin with, if you could just share, you know, we've been through a very difficult time in the past few months. How is the steel sector doing? And which are the sectors of consumption that are actually sustaining and which are falling?
Very good evening and thank you very much. As you have mentioned about the steel sector, we have seen the issues which were currently when COVID-19 came. And we all know that steel is a cyclic industry and it has seen its up and down in the last so many decades. So COVID-19 was one such case again. And when the government has taken a call of Atmanirbhar Bharat, it very well, you know, takes care of what steel industry is trying to do. And when we see the clarion call of Honorable Prime Minister on May 2020, and then he defines the Atmanirbhar Bharat that it rests on five pillars, that economy which brings in quantum leap and not incremental changes, infrastructure which should become the entity of the country, a system based on 21st century technology-driven arrangements, vibrant demography, the source of human capital and potential, and demand whereby the strength of country's demand and supply chain will be utilized to full capacity. So it involves almost all these pillars. Steel industry has a wider role to play. And when you see the India urbanization, which was which is 28% and has the potential to go to 50%, the rural sector demand is likely to pick up. It's less than 12 or 14. It's likely to go up to 15. And the aviation sector, which the government of India has planned, that the aviation sector, there are many new airports will come. There is a Udaan scheme and long haul that there is an airport at every district. Steel has its own use in infrastructure, which government has also envisaged that the production will go up. The auto sector was subdued because, not because of the COVID, but before COVID also auto sector was subdued. But now we all see a ray of hope. Because every challenge brings an opportunity also. When before COVID, it was a call that everyone should drive metro or go for the public transport on the climate change. In COVID time, it is that you know, should be safe and should be having your own vehicle. So all these things are also giving an opportunity how the auto sector will pick up the demand. And as such, the urbanization will go up, such sectors will also pick up. The other aspect is the growing of India horizontally and vertically. So as urbanization will go or the rural demand will pick up, there are opportunities for high-rise buildings. And steel plays a very vital role in that because compared to strength to weight ratio and open space, that has a very, very vital role to play. And if you see the steel to cement ratio in construction, Japan has 1.84, where India is 0.35. So there's a huge potential in that aspect also. And when we club it with the Atmanirbhar and the recent issues with China, that also you know, reminds me one of the story of Gautam Buddha. When Gautam Buddha was giving a discourse, at the end of the discourse, he told, "Jago samay nikla ja raha hai." And then after the discourse, when he moved with his famous disciple to the venue, so many people were going to the destinations. And one lady came and told that, "You told a very good thing at the end of the discourse. Jago samay nikla ja raha hai. I was about to perform in King's Palace and I almost forgot it." Then an old person came and he told that, "You know, I have been to materialistic thing and now it is a time for me for a spiritual upliftment." Atmanirbhar Bharat and going India to a self-reliant has its own wider ramification, which I draw from Gautam Buddha's story, that everyone trying to do its own, whether it's industry or a common person or the multi-sectoral approach. So the steel has a huge role to play. And if I compare with other metals or other material, it is the most recyclable material, so you can recycle it many times. And again, I recall one of the shloka of Kautilya in Arthashastra, where he says that kasht paashan dhatu nam kritva bhaven sevanam saddha chayata siddhotash vishnu prasadata, means metal should be treated with gratitude and it's the blessings of Lord Vishnu. That's the sustainability part which was there in the ancient India is again picking up, and I see great potential in almost all sector, right from construction to auto, will pick up in the coming days. Your question, specific question of how it has been in COVID time. Yes, April, May, most of the steel makers were 50%, 40%, but now almost all the major steel producers are running at 100% capacity. The prices are also at the pre-COVID level and production is 100%. In between, we have been exporting to China, but now we are seeing that the green shoots are coming in India also. And then as of now, it seems that the recovery is coming fast.
So thank you for that. Now, you know, looking at that, and we had this ambitious plan in the national steel policy, which was in 2017, if I recall. You were there present at the launch, there in the CEO's roundtable also we had. So do you think that given this COVID-19, is there any need to relook at that policy, or we stick to that policy going forward?
So COVID-19 is a, I would say, delay. It's not a defeat. It's a delay. And I'm sure that the kind of resilience which Indian economy and Indian steel industry in particular is showing, as we have moved to our 100% production, some push from the government, if it is given, which already government is trying, helping us in almost all the things. We know that ROTDP and BAT government is working on. If that comes, we are on track. And I won't say that it's a little delay, but then we'll be back on meeting.
I'll return to the government agenda a bit more. But if I were to look at the current steel sector and what we are producing, and looking forward, you know, in the emerging sectors, what are the three or four areas that India needs to focus on in the sectors and different types of steel to actually become Atmanirbhar as we go forward and reduce dependence on import? Because in some sectors, we import nearly 40 or, 35% of the total requirement. So what are those products and how do we actually become Atmanirbhar in them?
Yeah, so if you look at the import and export, sometimes we have been net exporter, sometimes we have been net importer. It's a balancing thing happening, but there are certain products which India should look at its own level. And one is electrical steel. So if you see FY20, electrical steel imports of CRGO was 40% and CRNO 57%. So together 97% imports under this category. Then we can also improve our capability to produce products like electro-galvanized coils, special metal coatings of HR galvanized, zinc, magnesium, aluminium, tin nickel coating products also. And then there's a great potential, as I was mentioning, that advanced high strength steels, wider coils and thicker plates to reduce such kind of imports. Then few API grades like X42, 46, 52, X56, X60, X65 are imported due to price and quality issues. So if you recall earlier in automotive products also, we were importing a lot. But then with greater collaboration with auto companies, Indian steel makers also started producing the steel required for the auto companies in India. So in API also, in the petroleum and others, we can also collaborate with those companies, understand their requirement better, and we can produce the material which they require.
So, I recall we had this session with the oil sector. In which I think there was complete agreement that what the oil sector needs, the steel industry can and will produce. Is this a model we need to actually look in, like the auto sector, and are there any discussions going on in the electrical sector? Are there any discussions, and what can be done?
So if you recall in that same meeting, many of the industry leaders, they have told that, when we have come up to the expectation of auto makers, making those products which suits their requirement, And with better collaboration with the petroleum sectors, we can also meet the requirement. So basically, issue is with the pricing and the quality and the meeting those exact specifications. So it's a little long journey, but then yes, we can do that.
So is the Indian steel industry willing to invest to upgrade the facilities and to produce these quality of steel that is required?
Yes. So many companies have also gone for this, and there are certain premium products which major steel producers are producing, and bigger companies have a greater R&D which they are trying to use, and these products they have a pipeline of producing. Minister of Steel is also following it up at a regular interval that how we can do the imports.
So including, you know, that there's a limitation on the width, right? So are people willing to invest in, you know, larger widths and all that to meet the demands of the sector? And, I think the first investment has already been made. Is more investment coming in?
So, sir, this COVID time, there has been certain, halt on the CapEx because there was little uncertainty on that. But now when the demand is picking up in India, the investment plan of the steel makers will also grow. If you recall the previous experiences like the IBC, it was the steel sector which has come to the rescue, and the consolidation in terms of CapEx or in terms of acquisition had happened. And it has been a continuous upgradation of the steel making in terms of quantity and in terms of quality, which is going on from last a decade. And Tata Steel Kalinganagar has come up. We have other steel producers are also, doing acquisitions and increasing the product portfolio.
Okay, so I think you initially alluded to the different things that government could do. Could you just expand on what are the four or five things that the government needs to do, including you had a very interesting session on logistics, reducing the cost of logistics. So what are the four or five things that the government could do to support the industry?
So one, the government is trying to do for the, making India also a steel export hub. Then the RODDP is one of the things which government is trying. Then the border adjustment tax.
So RODDP is basically a refund of the embedded taxes when you export.
Yeah, yes, yeah.
Okay.
Then there's a BAT, which also is being talked about when the import comes, how we can, border adjustment tax we can. As such, it is also linking it to the high taxation in the steel and the mining industry. That is one. Then the sourcing of raw material in India and availability of both your coking coal and iron ore, that has to be seen. The current regime of iron ore auction, which has again increased the prices of, the competitiveness of iron ore. There, the innovative approaches have to be followed, like logistics, as you rightly mentioned. Slurry pipeline is one of the area which always helps. And if we can get some approval of slurry pipeline along the rail line, then the logistics cost as well as the environmental impact will be low. So there are many such, ask. It's like Hajaru Khwahishe Aisi. So RODDP, BAT, lesser duty rolls, these are on the trade front. Cost of mining and availability of raw material. We still import a lot of coking coal from overseas. And it's a very fluctuating, this one. The flood in Queensland increases the coal prices to a very high extent. So if that uncertainty can be removed, that would also help. But the larger point, which I like to bring it here, which many times the makers and the policy makers ignore, is the co-product and the byproduct. So when we make steel, we also produce slags, blast furnace slags and LD slag. So blast furnace slag has its utility in cement making. LD slag can be used in ballast, road making. So there are certain progress, certain developments which have happened. And it's another uses also like soil conditioner, in agriculture, and there are also reports which say that it can be used in improving the marine ecology also. So when we are targeting 300 million ton steel making, then this co-products and byproducts, that also can be used for the overall concept of circular economy. As you mentioned about the logistics, So one is the improving the logistics cost, which you all know that LPI, the Logistics Performance Index score in India is 44, and Germany and others are very high, at very high level. But the co-products and by-products also should be handled or should have a lesser classification of freight. There should be lesser GST so that it can be used. Because what is happening, if you go some of the highways, you will see a stone quarry is being mined out. And the same LD slag can be used as a substitute. So one is the use of circular economy industry. And then second is, if we can, in blast furnace slag, like we are taking help of the cement industry, other industry, if they can use this LD slag, then 300 million ton capacity and all those things will have a better say and better, convincing part of it.
So I think, Mr. Sadiza, thank you for that. You actually very eloquently just talked about how the steel industry was impacted briefly in COVID, but now is recovered and, doing 100%. You've talked about the new types of steel that we actually require, the agenda for the government. And most importantly, running through your theme was this need to develop a partnership with either the customers at one end who consume your finished product, and the other is to develop a whole ecosystem where even your waste products actually become consumption products for somebody else. And they enable us to go into your circular economy and the green economy, as you called it. Thank you very much for sharing your views and also explaining to everyone the future is very bright for the steel industry. The 300 million target is fairly achievable, and COVID has not disrupted it. If at all, it's got a minor delay, but even that can be overcome if there's a V-shaped recovery. So thank you very much, Mr. Sudhir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.